By 2030, India's urban slum population is going to be about 600 million people. By some estimates, we need a toilet for every 20 to 30 people. That means we need 25 million usable toilets. Let's take a moment to think about what it is to live like without a toilet. It means walking out of your home in the middle of the night, hoping that the nearest public toilet is open when you desperately need it. It means women and children adjusting their body clocks or drinking less water, both of which are unhealthy. It means defecating in the open, which is unsafe and unhygienic. So here's the bigger picture. Globally, over 2 billion people live without clean, accessible toilets. That's one in every four people who don't have access to a proper toilet. India suffers the most. Over 2,000 children die every year due to lack of clean and accessible toilets. As a nation, with more toilets, we could be spending a lot less on treating preventable diseases. The need of the hour is an alternative solution to public toilets, one that is easy to maintain and is scalable. I'm about to meet an entrepreneur who's transforming public toilets from yucky to funky, making them smart and sustainable. Welcome to the series on entrepreneurs transforming the world. GARV in Sanskrit means dignity or honor. Meet GARV Toilets and its founder, Mayak. Today, GARV serves 140,000 people every day, most of whom are people who started using a toilet for the first time ever. The GARV Toilet model is one that covers the entire value chain, building toilets, operating and maintaining toilets, and even cleaning sewage. And GARV is already in four countries. Mayak, what is the size of the problem when it comes to lack of toilets in India?
Till the start of the Swachh Bharat mission, we had like 600 million people that were defecating in the open in India itself. And that's why globally it was called the open defecation capital of the world.
To solve such a large problem,
yeah.
What do you actually need?
There's a thinking that you need to build toilets, and that is the first stage of it. And so that's what the government did in India as well. But that is not the whole sustainable solution, so mm-hmm. to say.
I've noticed that in a lot of urban slums, there are some toilets. It's not mm-hmm. like they don't have.
Yeah.
So, is there a bigger problem still?
Even if we just consider the slum population, that is about 23.5 million odd people living in slum areas. These people are concentrated in, like 60% of these slum dwellers are concentrated in just six
cities.
Six states. And the thing is, if we want to build toilets for them, we need to have at least 500,000 toilets.
Now, let's take a closer look at the problem. A major chunk of India's public toilets are unusable thanks to irregular maintenance and frequent vandalism. A lot of Indians do not have a toilet at home because of lack of resources to build these, lack of awareness around the importance of toilets, and mindsets that prevent building a toilet inside the home. Right now, 26% of India still lives without a proper toilet. In 2015, India lost over $100 billion of its GDP to poor sanitation. That's 5% of the country's total GDP. But what's the connect? Well, it's got to do with health, non-productive days for adults, and non-school days for kids. Now, this problem is not just important to work on, but also an attractive business opportunity. As per recent estimates, the global sanitary economy is worth $150 billion. And in India alone, this is worth $32 billion. So how are you solving this problem, and how are you catering to, you know, the need that we need toilets that work, mm-hmm. that are just not just constructed and left,
mm-hmm.
and the void that is there in from the user side too?
We wanted to build a toilet system that could, you know, plug in these gaps. And that's where we came out with a solution, with a niche solution, which is kind of prefabricated toilet, which is made out of steel and could also be produced out of a factory, right?
Got it.
And so steel, because steel provides a longer shelf life, it cannot be vandalized easily.
Mm.
And it uses a lot less water to maintain. And further, we kind of also integrated the toilet systems with real-time monitoring infrastructure.
Okay.
That is Internet of Things sensors and other sensors that could monitor in real time that how the toilets are being maintained.
Smart toilet. A toilet that's got automated self-cleaning and self-flushing and can gather and monitor data around usage and maintenance through IoT integration. GARV's toilets are movable modular units installed at locations like slums, schools, refugee camps and public spaces. The number of toilets in an installation depends on the number of users. Let's look at some of the features that make GARV's toilets unique.
So once I open the door and I enter inside the toilet, the sensors automatically activate the light in the ventilation system and the red light indicates that there is someone using the toilet. Once I close the door, it will automatically flush and the floors will get automatically clean after every 50 uses, 30 uses. That depends upon the software inputs we give in our data. And the alignment of the floor is designed in a way that all the water goes in the drain. Now, in order to conserve water, what we are doing is we are using pressure technology. Normally, a flush takes around 5 liters of water to do one flush. Here, we are using only 1.2 liters of water per flush. It's made of stainless steel, so the life of this toilet is around 15 to 20 years easily. And after that also, it's 100% recyclable because it's stainless steel 304 grade. Also, we have smart sensor-based water taps. We are using a foaming effect for you guys. So normally, if you're using, say, 1 liter of water per use, here we are giving you only 200 to 300 ml of water. And in case of locations, you know, we use grey water recycling plants as well. In locations where there is no sewage line, we use bioregisters. And there is no electricity, we use solar panels. Any remotest of the locations, we can provide a community toilet solution.
The main idea is that we are serving people who have never been served. Plus, what we have started to do now, especially in the slum areas or the underserved areas, is to create a system where it's a one-stop shop for all the water, sanitation and hygiene needs of the people.
So you're evolving once you have that infrastructure to see what else you can do with that space.
If you provide a bouquet of services, let's say you are providing a water ATM there and you're providing a sanitary kiosk where people can purchase hygiene sanitary products, plus there could be a laundromat that could be set up. So if a slum dweller wants to avail a service from that one-stop wash solution, they can subscribe to the whole service pack. They can subscribe for their whole family for a month and use the services that they want.
So essentially, what you are doing is taking something that's quite unglamorous and glamorizing it by mixing in the bouquet of offerings. So it's not, when you see a toilet, you don't just think of it as a toilet. You think of it as a multiple of things that serves a need,
yeah.
Whether it's a moving population or it is a population that's in an urban slum.
We need to provide attractive products, products that could attract people towards it. And that's where even the smart toilets that we do, they are pretty different from what people have seen over the years. And when we came out with this niche product, we also kind of advocated with the government bodies, with the NGOs and CSRs that, okay, building toilets is one thing, but we also want to maintain these toilets in the long run. So that's where we started rolling out service, long-term service agreements with the government or the government as a channel partner for us, even with the CSRs and NGOs, where we could set up the assets and also maintain them for the long run.
Also, when you think about toilets, it's not just something what the government built.
Right.
Or what an organization came and built like a sponsored toilet somewhere, or some politician built it as part of his campaign, right? This is a far more sustainable, scalable business. But I want to know from you, why do you think it's important to approach it this way and not in any other way?
I think the scale of the problem is so huge that that we can't really provide a sustainable solution through charities or through grant funding.
GARV has been working extensively on the Indian government's Smart City initiative and with government schools in 6 states. It has also been working with the Turkish government, the UNDP and private organizations to build sustainable sanitation solutions for Syrian refugees. Today, GARV has nearly 800 toilets in 32 locations. When people pay for things, they usually value them more. As a result, the service or product they pay for keeps getting better. Toilets are no different. So at GARV, the primary revenue stream will be user subscriptions. These are expected to start at 300 rupees a month for a family of four. The secondary revenue stream is space selling for outdoor advertisements. And finally, there's the bouquet of additional services, such as hygiene product sales and drinking water kiosks. You and your wife build this together, so what's the hardest thing in doing this? Did you have to struggle for money at some point? Did you have to struggle to figure out the business model or the actual product? Or was there something else?
So for the 2.5 years that we were knocking on doors and doing pilots, everything, the investments that we did, it drained out. I think at that point of time, I started out looking for a job as well. So, but eventually things happened and we got some new projects and things started rolling for us. Mm. So just in about, I think, mid of 2017, we started getting good orders, good traction. After about 1.5 years, when we started rolling good projects, we also got some investor interest through IIT Kanpur with partnership with Wilgrow. They have a program called Invent. Mm. And they basically fund startups that are in the seed stage.
What has it meant for you personally as an individual to set off on this entrepreneurial path, to see the kind of things that you've seen at the grassroots, people starting to use your toilets, maybe even people who never used toilets before?
Highly satisfying. That is what I would say. Because when you see that smile on the face of little girls who have never had used who have never used the toilets in the first place, and when they see a different kind of a toilet in their school or maybe close to their home, it's that smile that's highly satisfying. Mm. So the sparkle in their eye. So that's satisfying. I think money can be earned in any manner, but apart from that, if you are able to change lives in some ways, that's actually very satisfying.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you.
Really lovely meeting you, and all the best in glamorizing toilets.
Pleasure.
Yeah, thank you so much.